Welcome to Many Voices.
Hello, one and all. Welcome back to Manly Voices. I'm Evan, also known as Manly Ankles. I'm back again with Grace.
Hello.
And we're playing Phoenix Wright Ace Attorney. Were you going to say something?
I'm still eating my cookie, and you said you wanted to wait till I'm going to eat my cookie.
Oh, well, you can continue to eat your cookie.
Thank you.
So, we're in the middle of...
Ring the bell if it bothers you that I eat my food.
So we're in the middle of the trial.
I like if you, you know... I think I should eat food.
I mean, you should eat food. That's just, like, basic survival.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So if you don't like, you're a monster.
There are just, like, certain times and places.
Well, I can't shove the food cookie in my snack bar. It'll get all crumbly.
And now, we are proving to Edgeworth that the clock had its clockwork removed the night of the murder. And now I'll show you the proof you like so much. The evidence that proves when the clockwork was removed is...
The phone.
Whoops. Take that! Take a look at this.
That's a very cute cell phone.
Ooh, you have a girly phone. You have a girly phone.
Wait, this isn't my phone. Listen.
Girl phone.
This is the defendant's cell phone, and it contains a recording.
Such a girl.
It contains a recording of a conversation she had with the victim
Everyone
on the day of the murder.
Like,
girly
phone.
Girly phone. Girly phone. Girly phone. Girly phone. Girly phone. Girly phone. Her boobs are still huge.
Order. Your cell phone. Your girly cell phone on Amazon right now.
Edgeworth is like, objection. Men can like pink. Your coat is an example of that.
Okay, first of all, it's maroon. Second,
like a magenta.
The defendant's cell phone. This wasn't brought to my attention. Perhaps Detective Gumshoe overlooked it.
The good detective better remember he's up for evaluation soon.
He's always up for evaluation.
I gotta say, I'm starting to feel bad for the big fella, but not so bad as to throw him under the bus for the sake of my defense. Let's hear the conversation. Shall we?
Oh yeah, I forgot it was my voice. So you want me to hold on to the thinker for you then? If you can.
If you can.
Hey, you should probably tell you. The clock isn't working right now. Huh? It's not working? That's lame. I had to take the clock right now, sorry.
September 5th, 9:27 a.m.
I didn't say that she actually took it that day.
Your Honor, I think this makes it clear the clockwork is already gone by the time this was recorded. Which was well before the witness even arrived at her hotel.
Okay.
Well, Miss May, would you care to explain this to the court? Just how did you know that weapon was a clock?
Isn't it obvious? I saw that clock before. What store is it again? I go to sell many. Oops, I forgot.
So the witness had seen it before. That would make sense.
Objection.
Does the defense have any objections, Mr. Wright?
Yes.
This is handmade.
The witness claims she had seen it before, but this directly contradicts a piece of evidence already submitted to this court.
Well then, let's see it. Please produce this evidence that will prove the witness had not seen the clock before.
Isn't just the clock?
Yeah, it's the clock itself. Take that! It's simple. This clock was never in any store, ever.
What? Stuff always have to be in stores.
A friend of mine made that clock. Only two exist in the world, and the one that isn't here is in police custody.
Impossible! Everything is sold in stores.
Miss May, I think it's high time you went shopping for a better excuse.
But unch.
Oh, excuse is not on sale today?
Oh?
Oh god.
She went super saiyan.
Super saggy, more like.
Dun, 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 dun. What's it to you, Porcupine Head? That stupid clock doesn't matter, okay? She did it, and she should die for it. Die!
Whoa, my God.
That was like
she's
my
got,
take
she's
in
so,
an voice.
Yeah, she's so scary, yet her boobs are so bouncy.
Whoa, let's not get ahead of ourselves. This is a court of law, and the witness will remain calm.
Shut up, you old fart.
Oh. Uh-huh.
Jesus Christ.
Did I, like, lose it? Twitch. I guess I did.
Scary.
Miss Mary, let
me
ask.
So you take her to bed, and you're, like, all up in it, and then, like, all of a sudden she just gets all insane like that, and you're just like, no.
I said, spank my ass! Spank it!
And you're like, look at that. Look at the time. Look at the time on my wrist.
Oh, gee, look at my wrist.
Yeah, look at my
wrist. Time to go.
Tell me, how did you know the weapon was a clock? Oh, dear. She's giving me the silent treatment. Does the defense have an opinion on this behavior?
Yes, the defendant should go... Or no, the defendant. Yes, the witness should go to time out.
Okay, this is it. Yes, Your Honor. Allow me to explain how I see the truth of the matter. Miss April May, you knew the weapon was a clock because...
You had heard about it.
The witness had never held the clock in her hand. However, she had heard that it was a clock.
She had?
That is correct, Your Honor. There's no other way she could have known the thinker was a clock. And I can show you the proof.
Well, this is interesting. Let's see it then. Show me evidence proving that the witness had heard the murder weapon was a clock.
The wiretap.
This is illegal evidence, but take that.
This whole game is illegal.
Have a look at this.
That?
I found this in Miss May's room. Oh my God, in her room. He lucky guy, he was in her room.
Oh, Piggly obtained.
Mr. Wright, please explain to the court what this is.
How could you obtain this evidence illegally?
Yeah, Miss April May, you were tapping the victim, Miss Mia Faye's phone, were you not?
Oh. That was well protected.
Objection! Your Honor, this is irrelevant. I'm not entirely sure that it is. Objection overruled.
Oh, snap.
It troubles me that our witness was in possession of a wiretap.
This is outrageous! Does the defense truly claim the witness was tapping her phone?
Yes.
Absolutely! Even if that was the case, which it's not, you still have to prove one thing. Did the victim ever say that the weapon was a clock on the phone? Can you prove that? I think not. Oh yeah? I think I can. It's simple.
What?
What? I can't do that in Edgeworth's voice.
What?
There you go. There we go.
Yeah, everything you said, I'm like, that was the judge. And that was the judge.
Here's my proof. The proof that victim said on the phone that the weapon was a clock is...
Take that! This thing that we just talked about.
I present the defendant's cell phone.
Yes, we've seen that.
It is very girly.
Listen once more to the conversation between the defendant and victim.
Mia, what's up? You haven't called in a while. We're in exchange. You shouldn't know when to... Once you hold on for me. Again? What's it this time?
It's a clerk. It's made to look like the statue of the thinker, and it takes you to team.
Miss April May, you used a wiretap to listen to this conversation.
I haven't been to tell you one yet.
What?
She hadn't been in the hotel room yet. When this call was made.
So? She still could have, like, heard it.
On the wiretap?
Yeah, like...
So she tapped them first and then went to stay in the hotel?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay.
That's how you knew the thinker was a clock.
That's how you knew the thinker was a clerk.
Am I wrong?
Objection!
Objection!
I want Mia to be alive again, because I like her voice a lot.
Your Honor, this is ridiculous! Your Honor, look at the witness's face! Does she seem amused to you?
Does she look amused to you?
The defense demands an answer.
The witness, answer the question and turn your offspring ringtone off. Did you tap her phone? Miss May!
Shh,
Shut up, all of you. What gives you the right to talk to me like that? You lawyer.
Oh, Boner gone.
It's not fair. All of you gang up on me like that. It's not fair. Oh, I'm the bad girl that is at
That did it. The courts see the real Miss April May now. She's really eight. Now to deal the final blow. Why the wiretap? Why did you tap her phone?
Because I wanted to know how she's banging all the dudes.
What's her Answer secret? The question.
Where's your secret? Do I have to? Isn't this a murder trial? Isn't tippity-topping irrelevant?
Gah! She's saying exactly what Edgeworth wants her to say.
That's what I usually do.
Miss May?
I'm really good at listening to what Dad's
telling. Oh my god. You're tapping the victim's phone. I hardly call that irrelevant.
While this court does not condone the defense's tone of voice, he has a point. Well, Miss May, do you have an explanation for the court? Can you prove you had nothing to do with this butter, even though you tapped her phone?
Ha! I'd like to see her pull that off.
Yay. She's eight. No, she definitely won't. She talks like a child.
Mr. Lawyer, I saw that evil, evil grin. You were probably thinking I'd like to pull that off, weren't you?
Damn it, she's good.
Well, you're not the first man who's thought of that, and of course I can. And I will.
Oh boy, she's gonna strip. She's gonna strip to the court, everyone. She's gonna strip. You can't be serious! No way! There are children in the audience!
Why are children in a murder trial audience?
I don't know. They couldn't get a babysitter.
Babe, I really want to go to this murder trial down the street, but I can't get someone to watch Tommy. I guess I'll just take him with him. Look at these gruesome murder photos.
Exhibit A. This is where the gray matter of the victim's skull was painted onto the windowsill.
Way, I say way, and I assure you I'm serious, Mr. Lawyer. Hump.
Hump?
Okay, so killing happened around 9 at night. Why, that's just when I was getting to see Stella.
Get out of here, you.
Let me just come over here.
No, she can't. She's noisy.
Sweet
no. Room service?
Yeah, iced coffee, I believe it was.
No.
Iced coffee, you know, like normal coffee, but cold. And if you don't drink it quick, the ice melts, and then you have like regular cold, but like watered down coffee. It's like...
Ice coffee? I've never heard of such a beverage.
Think I'm making this up? Ask the bellboy.
Ergo, the witness was not on the scene at the time of the murder.
Gah!
So where does that leave us?
I'm sorry. It is my great displeasure. You try so hard to be, like, on topic and, like, treating the show, like, really important. And I'm always the one that's eating food and getting distracted by puppos and...
It is my great displeasure to inform you... What?
I don't remember. That the witness appears to have been tapping the victim's...
The witness appears to have been tapping the victim's asshole.
Whoa!
However, that is a separate. Strike that from the record. With no bearing on the current case whatsoever. Her testimony stands. She saw the defendant Maya Faye commit murder.
No! They're gonna let her just walk away! There's no way I can win unless I tie Miss May to the murder somehow.
Well, does the defense have anything to say?
Well, come on, there's something. Call the bellboy as a witness?
Yeah.
The defense would like to call the hotel bellboy as a witness. There's something suspicious here, and I'm going to get to the bottom of it.
I think you've sunk in quite well enough already.
Objection! I object to calling the bellboy.
Why? What's your reason?
Because I hold that the wiretapping had nothing to do with the killing. However, if you agree... If you agree to one condition, I'll consent to calling this witness.
Condition? This is a court of law, young lady.
She's so cute. She's a big mastiff, but she's got so much personality. Every time I like slap the couch next to her, she's like,
Of course, that's nothing.
It's
on.
Like fucking Scooby Doo over here.
Of course, Torby
not
will always be.
Not fucking Scooby Doo. Just it's,
yeah.
It's
please
just
don't
Scooby-Doo.
Fuck Scooby Doo.
It's just Scooby Doo.
Although I'm sure there's Rule 34 of that somewhere.
Yeah, between him and Shaggy.
I was well.
Yeah.
If Miss April May's alibi is not called into question after you examine the bellboy,
it wouldn't screw him over my shoulder though, because I wasn't really ever doing it.
Then you will recognize that Miss April May was not the killer, thus she is innocent. And thereby you must also accept the verdict of guilty for Miss Maya
Faye.
What's
the name of the blonde dude?
Fred?
Yeah. Well, you know, I always thought he was like the player, but I definitely knew it in the movie when he's played by
Freddie Prinze Jr.
Yeah.
Yeah. That is my condition. What? I'd better find something
my condition is
in that
Freddie Prinze Jr. comes to the courtroom.
Yeah. Now introducing the bellboy as played by Freddie Prinze Jr. I don't remember what he sounds like. I'll try my best, though. Otherwise, Maya will be declared guilty on the spot. What should I do? Accept the condition, really. There's no choice. Alright, I've got nothing to lose except for, well, everything. Understood. I accept your condition. Fool. You fell right into my trap. Can I call a timeout?
Sure. No timeouts. Very well. The court calls Hotel Bellboy to the stand. Freddie Prinze Jr.
You gotta edit, like, Freddie Prinze Jr.'s face on this guy.
I'll do my best.
Just for the split second.
I believe we're ready for the witness to testify. He certainly does look like a bellboy.
Played by Freddie Prinze Jr.
I can't remember what the fuck he sounds like.
Yes, sir. I received your summons in the middle of work, sir. I'm happy to be of service.
Can we make it a little bit more southern?
Southern?
Yeah.
Okay.
That tea set looks rather heavy, so without further ado, the witness may begin his testimony. Very good, sir.
Like that?
You're so close to sounding like Obama.
Well, I don't want to sound like Obama. I want to sound like Freddie Prinze.
But you almost sounded like you didn't sound like Obama. But
you could have just told me to sound like Obama, and I
really
could have done it.
No, but I wanted to trick you into it.
I am the head bellboy at the Fine Gatewater Hotel in business for 4 generations. I believe I received a call after 8 p.m. from our guest, Miss May. She asked for an iced coffee to be brought to her at 9 p.m, sir. I brought it to her at precisely the requested time, of course. And then I took one look at her bedongas and...
I mean, just look at that picture. He's just... Look at... He's like...
yeah,
he's like
not even
pulling
trying
his cheek
to
down
hide.
To, like, stare.
He's not even trying.
He's like, do I believe my one eye?
And I delivered the iced coffee to our guest, Miss May, herself. I see.
I was looking at the time.
The defense may begin its cross-examination.
Yes. Well, the text is also really small on this app. Yeah. Right, I'm ready. I hope. This is it. If I can't prove Miss May was involved with the murder now, Maya will be finished. Alright.
I'm a head bellboy in the Fine Gatewater Hotel in business for 4 generations.
I'm just gonna do my regular voice for him now. I'm the head bellboy at the Fine Gatewater Hotel in business for 4 generations. Hold it! What exactly is it you do at the hotel? Why anything required of me, sir? I check in guests, I check out guests, I check them out very thoroughly, I clean rooms, I make beds, I even deliver room service, if it is what they said. Why are you speaking in rhymes? Grace is not paying attention.
I know, but this is really funny.
I'll look right, at
later.
It. Send it to me later.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Look at your Snapchat. Okay. I was petting Stella, and then I was recording it, and like I had my head on her, and then I like went to sit up, but then she like sat up, and her nose just fucking took out my, or her head just took out my nose.
No. Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm okay, but it's really funny in the video because you can see the exact moment that she
okay.
does it, and my face is like, argh.
I checked in Miss May personally. She
Phoenix,
had a very
control your assistant.
She had a very large bosom, you see. Are you always so prim?
Mr. Wright? You will refrain from asking frivolous questions.
I believe I received a call after 8 in the evening from our guest, Miss May. Hold it! Are you sure it was Miss May on the phone? Absolutely, sir. How can you be so certain? I checked in Miss May personally, sir. Not only did I see her in all her stunning radiance, but I also heard her voice. And then I saw them, and I... The point being, I remembered her quite well, sir.
She's been a giant dog! She came in the room as well as like, boom, 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 boom!
Yes, and then what then?
And then I was chased out of the room by this giant dog!
She asked for iced coffee to be brought at 9 o'clock on the dot, sir. Hold it! 9 on the dot, you say? Yes, I confirmed that detail several times. She was watching a program on the TV and wished to drink after she finished, sir.
It was called Dr. Phil.
9 o'clock? They showed Dr. Phil at 9? I thought he was on at 4.
You know what time he's on?
I thought that's what he was always on. At 4 o'clock?
I'm just surprised you know that.
Well, I don't know that for sure. I'm guessing.
Well, it's probably on some rerun on like the Oprah channel or whatever.
The Oprah channel.
What's the Oprah channel?
I brought it to her at precisely the requested time, of course. Hold it! Precisely 9 o'clock, then? Precisely, exactly, and most definitely, sir. 9 o'clock p.m. Wait, How can you be so sure?
She was watching Chopped, and then she looked over and saw a woman just get bludgeoned to death.
she was watching the meat get tenderized, and then saw the same thing over next door. Miss May was quite insistent that he be brought dead.
Imagine watching someone get murdered, and just in the background you hear, like... One of the Chopped Judge going like, it needs some more salt.
Needs more salt.
Oh, bear boy, I'd like iced coffee at exactly 9 o'clock. Something like that, sir.
We've been infiltrated.
Therefore, I knocked on her door, sir. She's all wet. Get her out. Leave. Riley knows how to leave. Stella does not.
Yeah, we got two dogs here. Yeah.
Therefore, I knocked on her door at the crack of 9 o'clock, sir. And I knocked on her crack at the crack of... me. I don't know. Why would she so be particular about the time?
I knocked on her dawn at the crack of... door.
We need to get this done. And delivered iced coffee to Miss Guest herself. One more time. I'll press him until he spills the tea. I brought it to her precisely... I delivered the iced coffee herself. Hold it! You are sure it was Miss April May herself? Go away!
I know what information we need to get, but I don't know how we get it.
We can't get anything out of this testimony. Absolutely, sir. Absolutely? Yes, it is. As in so very absolutely, it's an endearing mannerism of mine.
I'm endearing.
How come you're so very certain? Well, when I brought a room service, sir, the guests, favored me with an embrasse, sir. Embrasse? Isn't that French for embrace? It's French for kiss, sir.
I'm glad that you're reading it, because I would have just been like, she favored me an embrace, dear.
But not a French kiss, sir. More of a peck on the cheek.
Not a Spanish kiss or a Russian kiss, just a kiss on cheek.
Why would she have done that? I believe perhaps she was momentarily swayed by my prim demeanor, sir. It was a moment I shall never ever forget, sir. Sounds pretty fishy to me.
Yeah,
I think our Miss May was...
gross.
Smells like fish. I think our Miss May was up to something and wanted the bellboy to remember her. Alright, next time on Manly Voices, Jesus.
Look at Phoenix's weird hands. They look like little elephant.
He has massive hands.
Like, the ones on the right look like little elephant trunks.
I guess.
It looks like a little alligator.
Actually, you know what? I can't.
Like his thumb and his pointer finger look like a little alligator.
I don't think I can lower the text box like I can with other visual novels, but if you look on the knuckles of his right hand, they kind of look like little faces. Like the indents of the knuckles on either side are like a face.
I was going to say, on the other hand, the thumb and the pointer finger look like an alligator face.
I don't
So next time manly voices.
Yeah, next time we will get to the bottom of this bellboy.
Like, if you see the faces, ring the bell if you see even more faces.
Thank you, everybody, so much for watching.
And if you see even more faces, maybe talk to your doctor.
All right, until next time. Bye, everybody.
Bye-bye.